going to make him work for it. She is testing him. Why are you going to mate with a male who gives up? No, you're going to mate with a male who is persistent. The dominant male, the male who has lots of energy, the male who doesn't need to eat or drink or sleep. He will just, I'm behind you all the way, baby, kind of thing. The male who will follow you the whole day. Yeah, the females are going to pick the best available male. Yeah, survival of the fittest. That goes for just fighting for survival. That goes for fighting for the right to mate too, for reproduction.
Oh my God.
And submarines, gazelles, they need protection too. We give them their own little place. Okay, on your left, South Africa, 130 animals. Where the heck are they? I don't know. This is 65 acres. They're spread out. You're talking 2 animals per acre. But like I said, animals hang out with each other. So guess what? There'll be places where there's nobody, and then suddenly, boom, lots of animals. Oh, here we go. Coming up on your left, Patterson's eland and springbok. Eland is a large antelope, okay? So the big tan antelope
giraffes
are Patterson's eland.
Where? Down there.
And then the little tan and whites, those are springbok. Springbok get up to 80 pounds max. They're usually like 50, 60 pounds.
That's how much.
So they're small.
Right,
so you
now
know what? Cheetahs will go after them. They're going to have to run away from the cheetah. They're not going to fight back. So you know, they're fast. They can run 50 miles an hour. Look at the black stripe on the side. That black stripe is an advertisement. I'm a fast runner. I can run 50 miles an hour. You can't catch me. Neener, neener, neener. That's the racing stripe, folks. Showing off the swooshes on their Nikes, the stripes on their Pumas, folks. A racing stripe. Okay, do me a favor. Look at their big white rumps. Raise your hand if you see their big white rumps. Yes. See that? They were born with that. Why would you have a big white rump? So everybody will look at it. It doesn't make you feel self-conscious. It just makes everybody follow you to safety. That's a follow me mark. Okay? And sometimes you'll see them walking single file because they're following the rump in front of them. It's like a conga line kind of thing. Now, on your left, look at the big tan antelope. Oh, they don't have big white drums. They have black tails, and they have 4 black hooves, and they have 2 black elbow patches on their front legs. You see that? Follow me marks do not have to be on the rump, but it's going to be on the animal whose rear end you're looking at. Look at the 2 springbok, head to head, in front. Backing off.
Getting a fight.
Are those young males? I don't know. They could be females too. Yeah, the one on the left backed up a bit. Wherever you've got a social group, you're going to have a hierarchy. You cannot all be number one. You're going to have to fight for survival. Who's number one, number two, number three, all the way to number 20 if there are 20 of you.
Oh,
look,
rhino
on your left, a prehistoric
rhino
animal. No, this is Bumpu. Bumpu is a greater one-horned rhino from India and Nepal. I thought this was your Africa tour. Yes. Bumpu is
they
in
cut
here.
His
Let
horn
me tell
off
you his story. He's been here, what, 5 years? 5 years, I think. Maybe this is his 6th year, perhaps. He has sired something like 6 babies, okay? The pregnancy for a rhino is 16 months.
God damn.
More than a year, folks.
Like
you do not know if that baby's going to survive. Right after the mama gives birth, the male will try to mate with the mom again. Sometimes he will shove his own baby out of the way, okay? While the mom's trying to take care of the baby. It is instinctive. They will mate with the female again. Well, Bopu has had 6 babies, so we're giving the females a little vacation. Bopu is on sabbatical, okay? A little timeout for you, Bopu. But I was just doing my job. We know. We thank you. But you know, you just want to give the females a little time off. Give them a chance to miss you, okay? Just email them from time to time, okay? And on your left, look at the nice horns. Look at these long horns of the South African oryx, also called South African gemsbok. They live at the edge of the Kalahari, edge of the desert. Look at those horns, okay?
Look at them, look at us.
These gemsbok get up to 400 or 500 pounds. And they all look the same, male or female. Why? Because you live close to the desert. You better be able to fight back.
A donkey.
What, you're a female?
A
I'm petite, I'm demure, I'm a lady, you should let me eat first. No. The females are just as big as the males. I am woman, hear me roar, get out of my way, Bustler. They will fight back.
Because the draft.
For 2/3 of all antelope species, the males and females are equal. Because survival's difficult enough. You're gonna, what? Did you see that?
No.
Oh. One just approached with that. Oh, tail lifted up. What's going on? I think that is courtship. Yeah, they look very similar, don't they? Oh, the female is lifting her tail. The male is standing right. Oh, did I tell you it's mating season? It's mating season. Cold, wet weather, mating season. What's going on now? Twinkies, I can't see. He's gonna follow her around. And that's a female who just got up. There's a male standing right behind a female.
Keeps talking, that's why they don't do it.
And the other female who's got up is like, I'm gonna go for a bite. Okay. You do whatever, whatever.
It's gonna keep talking.
And on your left, look in front, look at the big black animals. Against the wall, Cape Buffalo. You see them?
Do you get a picture of the giraffes?
They do not blend in. Are
you going close to them?
Think about it. Cape Buffalo get up to 1,500 pounds, 1,800 pounds, sometimes 2,500 pounds. When you're that big, you know, you can't really hide. What, you're going to run away from danger? You're going to watch out for danger? No. I'm going to become the danger. Cape Buffalo wear all black to intimidate you. I told you, black and white are the two most visible colors. Cape Buffalo will charge at you. They will trample you to death. Okay, they kill lions, they kill people. You see the black color? Leave them alone. Do not go to the dark side.
Okay, Mr. Chow.
Most animals will run away. Cape Buffalo are too heavy to run away. So guess what? They run at you. They charge at you instead of running away from you. Male zebra underneath you on your left. Zebras are very aggressive animals, okay? Grabby zebras in particular. This male has been really aggressive when it comes to courting the females. And the females have bite marks on their rear end. So guess what? We put the man's like, okay, a little timeout. We do this periodically because his behavior is not quite changing.
He's wild.
So we're trying to get him to realize, stop being so aggressive. The females will mate with you, but stop biting them. Okay? It is natural, but he just seems to do it a lot. So we gave him a little timeout. Now we go north. We go into Central Africa. The orange antelope are Uganda cob. The grayish tan antelope standing, sitting at the crest of the hill. Greater kudu. Do you see these animals? Aren't they smart? They're right at the edge of the hill. They're at the top of the hill. They can see all the way down. That's a nice vantage point. Oh, on your left. What's going on? Why is your tail lifted up? You're probably going to the bathroom. Or did you just finish? I don't know. That's a roan antelope, folks. Here are some more roan antelope. Look, multitasking. Watching out for danger and eating at the same time.
You shit.
And these roan antelope get up to 400-500 pounds. They live in Central Africa. Lots of rain in Central Africa. Lots of green. Lots of food. Different habitats. Survival's easier now. But the roan antelope, the male is slightly bigger. But they look pretty much similar because, you know what, they're big. So if there was a huge difference in size, then maybe the females would not be able to compete for survival. So the females are, you know, still close. And the males probably outweigh the females by maybe 100
pounds. Get a picture with like all that.
Look at that beautiful view on your left, folks.
The view.
And look at the forest on your right. Forest animals are very shy. You know why? Because there's lots of trees. The trees allow you to hide behind them. But the trees also allow other animals to hide behind them. The predators will hide behind the trees. The prey animals will hide behind the trees. Predators will go looking for the prey animals, so the prey animals are kind of nervous. So folks, forest animals are shy. They hide. Two birds on the island with a yellow crown on the head. Those are West African crown cranes.
It just pooped.
Now look in front of you on your right. Look at the dirty orange antelope. Zambezi lechwe. You see them? Why are they not hiding? Because they're not from the forest. Front right. All the way to the front. Where are they from? They're from Central Africa, grass. Why are they in your forest area? Because the forest animals are hiding. Summertime, you will not see the forest animals at all. So guess what? We didn't want you to think there was nobody in there. So we do mix animals up together. You know, it's for your viewing pleasure, too. We want you to see the animals. We want you to feel like you are on safari. I want you to look at the rhino on your left. Behind the tree. This is Angalifu, a northern white rhino.
Where? Oh, there, right by the tree.
Do you know what he's doing? Whatever the heck he wants. Because he weighs more than 4,000 pounds. When you are that big, oh, you can sleep the whole day if you want to. Nobody's going to bother you, really. Look at that. He looks like a big rock, doesn't he? He does blend in. He is from, well, his ancestors are from Central Africa. Used to be 600-700 of them in the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Freedom.
Unfortunately, 15 years of civil war in that country has killed all the northern white rhinos in the wild and up to 5 million people. We're human beings. We're at the top of the food chain. We got all this technology. We got the intelligence. We got the knowledge.
Oh,
yet we still can't get along with each other. That's sad and scary, folks. And that's why here in the park we're saying, yeah, we can get along with each other. We can find a way to make the earth a place where we can share with everybody else. Humans, animals, plants. If you look on your right, undeveloped land on your right, these bushes are laurel sumac bushes. Yeah, very common plant you see in coastal sage scrub, which is the habitat found in Southern California. The sad thing is, only 10% of the original habitat is left. The other 90%, what happened to it? Got taken over by humans. We built homes, towns, and cities. So on your right, 800 acres of undeveloped land. We're not touching it. We're going to leave it alone. Aloe on your left. So we save the plants too. Aloe, over 400 species of aloe in the world. They are from Africa and the Mediterranean. You might have them in your backyard.
Oh, look, it's running.
We change the world around us, folks, to suit our needs. And you know what? It's like, I don't know when, but people start realizing, you know what? Maybe we went a little too far in changing the world. Yeah, we're killing off lots of species. And you know, we don't want to get to the point where we're the only ones left on the planet. Yeah? It would be a pretty sad, boring existence. And that's why the zebras on your left down below you are separated from the other animals. Because they're kind of aggressive. So these are the females and baby that is, I think, 2 years old. 1 year? 2 years old? I'm not quite sure.
Can't tell.
Gravy's zebras. Like I said, they're generally aggressive. Gravy zebras bite and kick and stomp. They chase other animals out of the territory. They do not play well with others. They run around with scissors. It's not that they're mean. They're just wild animals, okay? These are all wild animals. If we're going to release them back to the wild, we want to make sure they stay wild, that they're not going to be approaching humans. They have to avoid people. They have to have that fear of people. And folks, some animals are not releasable back to the wild because they're too used to people. But for the most part, I'll be honest with you, we have 450 animal species here. 25 have been returned to the wild. The other 425, well, sometimes we don't need to send them back to the wild. Their numbers are stable. They're doing fine. And sometimes to send them back to the wild would be a death sentence. So we're not going to do that. So what do? We send them to other zoos. We send animals to other zoos. We've been here 44 years, 1969. We've had 41,600 babies in those 44 years. Obviously, they're not here. Yeah, we keep records. We know who's related to whom. We know who's the father of whom, who's the son, who's the daughter, the cousin, whatever. So we send animals to other zoos, and guess what? We get animals from other zoos, too. They keep records, too. We cooperate with each other. We communicate with each other. It's pretty cool. Like I said, we're sharing. Now, on your left, okay, the shaggy brown animals are what we call Elipsin waterbuck. Look at the coat. It's brown. It's thick. Does not live in the desert. Lives close to the water. That's a water bug. The females do not have horns. The male does. You see this? The females don't need horns. I live close to the water. There's lots of